conclusion for this result. The action of chiral self-gravitating model represented by the following way. So the action contains of gravitational part and of matter part, which represented by chiral fields, which interact in the target space or chiral space with metric HAB. The potential of interaction of fields also include in this action. Here R is a scale curvature, kappa Einstein's gravitational constant, and we should pay attention that we have two spaces. A metric of a space-time, and also we have HAB, a metric of a chiral target space. And this is interesting that may be some interaction, some connection between symmetries of these two spaces, chiral spaces and space-time. And potential of interaction W. By standard way, we consider the system of equations of this model, and as far as we know the energy momentum tensor for this model, we can represent Einstein equations in the form which most suitable for consideration of the gravitational equation, where in the left hand side we have a Ricci scale, Ricci tensor. The dynamic equation of the chiral fields contain the derivative with respect to each field, also contain the derivative of the potential, and additional part which concern internal or target space metric. So in some sense, it will be presented as the term which contain Christoffel symbols of the second kind, if we will write down these equations in some another form. And this means that the internal space play important role in dynamic equations of the chiral field. Gravitational theories with high derivatives can be reduced to the Einstein gravity with additional scalar field. And this model afterward can be presented as chiral self-gravitating model. In the article Naruka et al., they found the way to reduce the model with higher derivatives of the first order with respect to scalar curvature and the second order with respect to scalar curvature. They introduced Lagrange multipliers in the action, and you see somehow the nonlinearities from gravitational part shifted to scalar field part. And this simplifies the way of understanding and solution, finding solution for such type of models. Note that here we have additional fields, phi and b, which play important role in consideration of this model. So there are two possibilities to reduce this model, which depend on the second derivative with respect to field B, equal or not equal to zero. From this, we can find different models. And the result for the case when this second derivative does not equal to zero, we find the transformation here. And we see that we have some field phi, which play a role of R, scalar curvature. And for this, the B also equal the D'Alembert operator, acting to the phi. This is new field. In this case, this model can be reduced to the model with the fields using the conformal transformation of the metric from non-minimal interactant from Jordan frame to Einstein frame. And this action contain Einstein scale factor, scale curvature, and also the kinetic part of the fields and the potential part of the fields. So this model can be reduced to the chiral self-gravitating model if we additionally will request the following equality. So we introduce another functions, and under this presentation, we obtain the chiral self-gravitating model with the metric of the target space. This is three-dimensional metric of the target space and potential, which contain all three fields. If we consider the case when the second derivative with respect to B of phi of F, we find another model. And this model, we can see that more complicated because it contains the box phi and some functions here. So under this, we couldn't represent the model in the form of chiral self-gravitating model without additional suggestions. So we can choose the following relation between function, and for this case, the model can be transformed to the chiral self-gravitating model with two-dimensional chiral space and potential, which contain both fields here. Let us consider the special case of such type of model, where we have only two terms in comparison with the case which considered in the work Naruka et al. So the simplest maybe presentation of this function that they have the FR part, F1R, and linear on the kinetic term of the scalar curvature with some function, kinetic function here. And such model have been studied in the work Cervone et al. And we studied this model directly in terms of scalar curvature in cosmology. But in spherically symmetric space-time, for example, investigation performed from a chiral self-gravitating model approach in the work Cervone et al. In classical and quantum gravity. Also in work published in space-time and fundamental interactions. So if we consider the model, FR kinetic scalar curvature model, and we consider the action which contain non-minimal interaction. So this is in Jordan system. And we can use Weyl transformation, conformal transformation to go to E-frame. Choosing that omega squared equal to lambda, lambda here, the scalar field, not constant. And after that, we have the resulting action, which have some coefficients here. So this is kinetic term for the scalar field lambda. And therefore, we can make some transformation, which give for us possibility to reduce this model with first standard kinetic term, canonical kinetic term. And the action will have the following form and can be presented as chiral self-gravitating model. The target space metric Presented by the following form, we have diagonal metric with H11 equal to 1 and H22 equal e in the power minus 2 square root 2 third psi chi and x on phi. The non-diagonal term equal to 0. And potential also have the form which contain phi and phi 1 on phi. In this case, we have some function which we can adopt to the solutions. And this means that we can find some gravitational FR theory, which suggested to these solutions, which we obtained, which adopted to these solutions. Now, let us consider the spherically symmetric static space-time published in the work Chiron, Fabris, Fermin. And this situation gives for us possibility to find the solutions of gravitational field equations and for chiral field equations. So we can see the model which represent the gravity with higher derivative in the form of chiral cell gravitating model. And model equation for spherically symmetric space-time, they are not very easy to solve, but we may use the harmonic coordinates, which give this term equal to zero. So these terms will be equal to zero in harmonic coordinates, and the system equations for harmonic coordinates take the following form. Besides, we can see from equations, this is equations 28 and 30. If we express W from first equation and insert in equation 30, we find the relation between metric coefficient, which give for us the relation formula number 33. So we have, this is field equations, and we have the equation for gravitational field equation. To solve this equation, we use special case of scaling transformation. So we set the scalar field xi, he is equal to special constant. So he equal to this constant. This correspond to identical conformal transformation with omega squared equal to 1. Under this request, we can solve this set of this system of equation with additional suggestion for function f1 on phi. First of all, we can consider the case when the potential equal to zero. That is, we can find quasi-GR solutions if we choose F1 equal phi divided by 2. And the potential in this case equals zero. And also, if we additionally set x on phi equal to zero, we arrive to general relativity case. Therefore, we can solve the system of equations and first relation which we can obtain, this is nu double prime equal to zero. And after that, we can find the function nu linear on the generalized radial coordinate u. And also we can study equations of gravity and scalar field. It is possible to find that equation for scalar field can be represented by the following formula 44, where we have x function on phi and derivative of phi with respect to u squared, and this should be constant. So we can a few options when c equals zero, when c less zero or more zero, and to investigate these results, inserting this into solutions. We find two classes of exact solutions, and for the case when such relation holds. So k equal to zero, we can obtain the first class of exact solutions where the beta one equal the following part contain linear term in un, a logarithm of u with some constant of integration u star. So the second class of exact solutions correspond to the case when k does not equal zero. K does not equal zero, and it may be represented by the following form. Here we see this is linear part with respect to u, and here we see two options, also plus or minus a sign for solution. So this is in some sense two solutions. So the second class can be multiplied by two. Two classes of exact solutions we can find for the case c equal to zero. We can obtain the metric of these solutions. And for both solutions, we can represent the solution in terms of function theta. And for this theta, we have two options for the first class, theta equal u minus u star in the power minus two. And for the second class, this expression also in the power minus two give for us solution or for the metric component. For example, if we consider the special case when k more than zero and c connected with k, then we find the theta 2 function in the following form 50. And for k less than zero in the form 51. Therefore, we can generate the exact solutions for chosen dependents x on phi or phi on u, taking into account condition which connect this both x and phi prime squared, and then reconstruct full function phi on u or x on phi. Another possibilities we can find if we consider the ansatz between all solutions b equal m nu, where m some constant and m does not equal one and does not equal minus one. In this case, we can obtain the solution for nu double prime, the second derivative with respect to nu. We can solve this equation. And also, now we choose another ansatz. So F1, we represent it as phi divided by two and some function F2 on phi with some constant as multiplier. In this case, we can say that phi divided by two, this is GR-like model. And this is differences between GR model and model which we investigate. The gravitational equation take the following form. And chiral field equations has more complicated form in this case. Therefore, we can use equation for gravitational field and insert in this equation chiral field equation. Then we can find the equation of dynamic of chiral field, and also it contains the term like for GR like solution. And this means that we obtain some another solutions, because this combination could not be equal to constant, because we have some term with the function mu. So we can find three type of solutions according to a setting constant C1 equal zero, more than zero, and less than zero. So we see that for this case, M squared should be more than unity. Therefore, we can study two branches of the solutions. First branches with u less than u star, then we have under logarithm positive expression, and for the case u more than u star, we have also a positive function as logarithms argument. So for this solution, we have m belong to the following interval. We may find the function f2, and substitute this and other solutions. We can find the function f2 in terms of u. And also we can use this knowledge in chiral field equation, and we find the result for the chiral fields and derivative squared and function x on phi, which still undefined. Therefore, we want to obtain canonical scalar field or phantom scalar field, depending on the sign here. And for this case, we have to choose x equal unity, and phi then will be phantom field, and the solution for phi, this is the coefficient and logarithm of u, and here constant of integration marked by star. Then we find the solution f2 on phi, and this means that we have the in some sense phi plays role of R of scalar curvature. Therefore, we have model which contain phi divided by 2, so this is standard term for Einstein gravity, and differences in this term. So this is e in the power plus minus 2 mr with some coefficient depending on m. And therefore fr can be represented in the following form by this expression. So this theory can be considered as theory FR plus higher derivative of the first order, which give for us solution, which we will investigate further. Then we have to study asymptotes for the case which we considered, and we find that for the case C1 equal to zero, can be described by the following forms of solution. And asymptotes here, we see that the metric coefficient E in the power 2 nu tends to zero, so we have a horizon, and other tends to infinity. For all these values, values of M, we have E in the power 2 nu tends to infinity.
And
pardon?
You have 10 minutes more.
10 minutes more, thank you. Mm-hmm. Well, for all values, we have no candidates for horizons. And the solution 72, this solution a cold black hole, and we have quasi singularities when u tends to plus minus infinity. So we have an example of cold black hole. Another solution also considered for another values of constant C1, but also it is of interest to see exceptional solution, which we have to consider separately. This is beta equal minus nu, and so we excluded the case M equal minus one, and therefore we study this as special case. The idea, once again, the same, and we can integrate from 74 this equation and can find solution which represented by the formula 78. For chiral fields, we have once again this combination, and we have a relation which give for us possibility once again for canonical or phantom field with x equal one. We can find the solution. In this case, we have phantom scalar field, and the form of this scalar field rather complicated. This U sum shifting generalized radius coordinate. And also we can, for x equal to one, we can find the chiral fields integrating the equation 81. Also, we have some relation for constant which necessary to hold the solution for field equations. So the metric which we obtain represented by the following form and defining the square root 2 multiplied by x by u minus 2 c1 and k bar by this way, the metric can be written in the following form. We can see that it is possible horizons when x tends to plus minus infinity. Therefore, these solutions once again give for us cold black hole, similar to the case discussed above. So, conclude this situation, we can say that using Naruka-Yashida-Mukoyama procedure, we can represent modified FR, Nabla R squared, box R models, and their truncated versions as chiral self-gravitating model in target space of 2 and 3 dimensions. Considering such presentation, we find examples for exact cosmological solutions which are adequate to observational data of Planck 2018. This is in another publication. We consider cosmology in this talk. We consider spherically symmetric solutions. Also, we can find solutions and method of construction of them for the models with additional matter fields, including barotropic perfect fluid. It is interesting to know that the solutions pointed out on the form of FR, Navla R square box R function, leads to obtained solutions also. We can extend our approach for the theory which contain derivatives more higher order and derivatives of the second order D'Alembert operator, D'Alembert operator, and squared D'Alembert operator, and so on, using the target spaces with more than 2 dimensions. So for other model, we also can make reduction to the model, chiral self-gravitated model with high dimensional target spaces. Thank you for attention.